Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. My name is Emily and I talk a lot about Salesforce. Today we're going to be going over the top 5 certifications that I think will boost your career within Salesforce. So I talk a lot about Salesforce certifications. Personally, I really like Salesforce certifications. I like the studying process. I like the feeling of achievement when I get one. So I think they're really, really useful. There's something that you can do outside of your job to help you land another job, help you land a better job, a better paying job, a better quality of life job, whatever you're searching for. Salesforce certifications can help. And it's also why my husband and I started Salesforce Upskill, which is how we create certification courses to help you get Salesforce certifications easily and quickly. So if you want to check that out, that'll be in the description down below. Some will say that the Salesforce certification system is a little broken because a lot of people can cheat the system, which don't do that. You'll get your Salesforce certifications taken away. Really try to show your experience in addition to getting those certifications through sharing on LinkedIn, sharing on Twitter, sharing on whatever platforms you are on, if you're blogging or YouTubing, whatever. But they are still one of the best ways to show competency in a certain area of Salesforce, or that you have competency in a Salesforce adjacent tool. So let's go ahead and jump into this list with a few caveats. One, this is going to assume that you already have a Salesforce associate and admin certification, because those two are the first two that you should typically get within Salesforce, and then they were going to top the list regardless of what else was going to be on this list, because they are going to show that you have some level of proficiency and they're the first ones that are getting you started and a jumpstart into your Salesforce professional life. Other criteria is that these are going to, one, boost your career, which means they're going to either boost your title or boost your pay, or both. Two, another one is that they're going to strictly be Salesforce. This isn't going to include any other Salesforce adjacent tools. And finally, this does not include CTA, because CTA is a beast of a certification and it's really hard to get. That is just too hard, but it's hard for a good reason. This is going to be in no particular order, and I would love to hear your thoughts on if you agree or disagree with this. So the first certification is going to be the CPQ certification, which is going to stand for cost price quote. This is going to be a way to build out a quoting system within Salesforce. The certification one is really difficult, and so it's hard to get, and there aren't a lot of certified professionals in CPQ. It's also in really high demand as far as jobs go. And once you get the certification, it's really easy to land a consultancy job or as a CPQ admin at a company. So let's look at an example of CPQ. Let's say that you are building a computer. Regardless of if it's a Mac, like I've got here, or if it's a PC, there are certain computer parts that you're going to need when you are buying a computer. And for sake of this example, let's say that this is a custom computer build, and so you're going to need a lot of different pieces from the company that you're buying from. So you're going to need, let's say, a display, you're going to need a keyboard, you're going to need a mouse, you're going to need a motherboard, a CPU, a GPU, as well as possibly some RAM. And there are different brands of all these different things. There are different ways to increase or decrease the performance of your computer based upon these certain things. So let's say in the process of building out this computer, so let's say you are going to have a 4K monitor, you're going to choose a 3080 Ti GPU, and then you're going to choose an i7 CPU. So now this might not make a lot of sense if you're not super into computers, but these are all different parts, and these are specific parts. So now when you are in Salesforce and you're building out this computer with the person who you are buying it from, they're going to choose those specific pieces and those specific parts as different selections in this computer buying process. So now Salesforce allows you to have a list of all the different CPUs, all the different GPUs, and allow the salesperson to go in and choose these different parts. And then CPQ will calculate how much it's going to cost, if there are any different like colors that you want to have on your case, or if there's a particular mouse that you want to have but in this color or in this size, then there'll be different features of it, as well as any discounts that might be applied at the holidays, or if you have extra inventory in one piece versus another. CPQ will be able to calculate all of these and help you deliver a quote to the client based upon those selections. This is extremely complex to set up, and that's why it is one of the number one certifications to get as far as to boost your career, because once you understand it, which it is very difficult to understand, then it is in high demand because people want to use it. Attached to this, while there isn't a specific certification for this yet, is billing. So if you want to bill through Salesforce, you might be asked to do that in your CPQ position. Beyond this, the next is going to be Experience Cloud. So this is a way to create an external site that lands back to your Salesforce. Well, I guess it could be external. It could also be internal facing for your users. It is going to be a website that is attached to Salesforce, but doesn't look like Salesforce. So think of like when you're trying to pay your water bill, if you have to log into your specific municipality in your particular city or your county, however you're getting your water, sewer, electric, however you're logging into that, that is going to be an example of an experience site where you can log in and pay your bill. And if you're paying your bill, it's probably going to link back to some type of payment gateway. It could be billing for through Salesforce, it could not be. This could also mean it could be a blog for your company, it could be your company's website that intakes leads, this could be an FAQ site for your product. If you are selling a product and it's hard to use, or your customers may have frequently asked questions about it. An example of this was my husband and I recently finished out our basement. This is where I'm filming now, which is great. But we were going to Home Depot to look at some carpeting, and we had our particular selections put out, and then we realized, oh, this is built with both CPQ and Experience Cloud. So how does this work? The Salesforce CPQ part, it input all our different selections for the pad that we wanted for our carpet, the particular quality, if we wanted warranty, what the particular color of the carpet was, what all the different selections that we had were. And then it gave us a quote. So now how do we get this quote? We got this through an Experience Cloud site that was different than their normal just browsing, shopping, picking out your selection for a Christmas tree type of site. So when we were making the selection, we could do that through an experience site of we wanted this pad, we wanted this option, and then it would go into CPQ and then spit out a bill or spit out a quote that then we would get in our email. And for those of you wondering, this is the carpet. It's really nice and squishy. And the reason why Experience Cloud is so useful is because it is in high demand, and that's why it's going to boost your career. It's really nice for companies to be able to have their systems integrated. Kind of goes back to the whole Salesforce thing about Customer 360, where all their data can be in one place. So that's why Experience Cloud is so useful. So the next certification is going to be Developer 2. So now there are a lot of certifications that you have to get in order to get Developer 2. Mainly you're going to need to get Developer 1, which is a prerequisite. And in the certification, there's two parts to it. So you have to complete, I think, 4 super badges. And each of the super badges has prerequisite badges that you need to complete in order to access the super badge. And then in addition to those super badges, you're going to need to get the multiple choice question passed in order to get the certification. So I think that the super badges and the certifications can be done in any order, but you do need to have both to get the certification. So why is this certification so good for your career? It's because this certification shows that you actually are a developer, more so than the Developer 1 certification does, more than just about any other certification. This one will show hiring managers and recruiters that you know what you're talking about when you are a developer, other than having actual development experience on Salesforce. And it's what those hiring managers are going to be searching for and recruiters are going to be searching for when they're looking to hire a developer. So another reason why this is so great is because those super badges are going to be having you do hands-on development challenges to be able to pass the super badge and having you demonstrate a knowledge and a proficiency in development. I do recommend though that if you are looking for a developer job and you do have Developer 2, still be working on your side projects as a developer to be able to show and get past that first interview stage to show that you know what you're talking about, that you have experience and that you're passionate about development on the Salesforce ecosystem. All right, so the fourth certification in this list is going to be Advanced Admin. This is going to be because a lot of hiring managers and recruiters are going to be searching for this when hiring for admin roles as well as senior admin roles. Other than experience as an admin or as a senior admin, this is going to be the number one way to differentiate you from a pool of admins, that you are a more experienced admin and that you are a more knowledgeable admin. Personally, I am not a fan of this certification. I don't like it. There's a few reasons. I don't necessarily think that this shows a good proficiency that you are a senior level admin because it covers a lot of one-off permissions that you aren't going to necessarily be using at all in your Salesforce admin career. I think that there are a lot of other things that you could be tested on more in depth that would show your proficiency as a senior level admin more so than just the one-off permissions that you may or may not use. And there is a strong disconnect between the fact that hiring managers and recruiters will use this to search for when they're hiring senior level admins, but then when a senior level admin actually does. So that's why this one is on the list, even though there's that strong disconnect. So the final one here is going to be the Application Architect Certification. So this one we will get automatically when you complete 4 certifications. This one's going to be App Builder Platform Developer 1, data architect and the sharing and visibility architect. This is what I would think puts you as a senior level admin on the track to being a solution architect of Salesforce, where you are designing different solutions and you are putting out projects that are well thought out, that are going to work well, that are well architected. It helps you just to understand a lot of the different aspects of Salesforce because it covers so much. Well, the app builder is going to tell you what the difference is between an admin and a developer. In studying for developer one, you're going to learn some of the basics of development on Salesforce and the back end of Salesforce a little bit better. Data architect is going to cover a lot of the data model and what pieces of the data model do, what the limitations are. And sharing and visibility is going to be like the data architect, where it shows you the data model, but just for security and visibility. So who sees what and what the different features are for you to be able to share and see different things within Salesforce. So I think that that is a more well-rounded indication of a senior level admin than the advanced admin certification, but this one will definitely boost your career and allow you to get some really awesome opportunities. So those are the top five certifications that I think will boost your career within Salesforce, especially in this next year. A lot of these were either specialty certifications or they were getting you into another role other than admin or just a vanilla entry-level admin. So I did complete this list with my husband, who is a 15-time certified. I think I'd have to go check his LinkedIn. A 15-time certified application architect of Salesforce, and he had some honorable mentions here that he would include. So that is this list. A lot of these are going to be actually architecture certifications. The application architect, as far as architecture certifications, is more of a general architecture certification that you know a lot of the basic architecture of Salesforce. There are some other architecture certifications that you could get. Those are going to be system architect, which will, once you have application and system architect, you'll be able to sit for the CTA exam, which is the technical architect, which is a really difficult one, but even just having those two certifications are great. System architect also has another four certifications that you need to get in order to qualify for the system architect certification. And then it's going to be B2B and B2C solution architect, which those ones are a little bit different, where you're not automatically given the certification when you complete the prerequisites. You'll need to sit for that certification after those prerequisites. And then one of his top honorable mentions is going to be OmniStudio, especially if you're going into the consulting space. This one is really, really needed. And then finally, my top honorable mention was going to be the Tableau and Einstein Analytics certification, because Einstein Analytics is somewhat of an AI, as well as Tableau is going to help you visualize your data and help with reporting. It's a highly visible position where you are creating those reports and wanting to narrow it down on certain pieces of data and KPIs to help the business make better decisions. And Einstein Analytics is going to be harnessing some powers of AI that's within Salesforce, and so it is on more of the cutting edge of what is popular within Salesforce right now. So I hope that you found this video helpful. If you did, be sure to give it a like, subscribe, tell me what certifications you would put on this list and why you would choose those. I'd love to hear. I'll catch you guys in the next one.